All right, so welcome to my talk today, and I'm continuing Boric series. Unfortunately, I didn't put some videos yesterday because yesterday was a very special day. We did the World Homeopathic Summit and it was very popular, and I'm so grateful a lot of people watched it. And so before I go ahead, I wanted to share with you that I'm going to do one webinar also again. Let's see if I can. Yeah, this is my webinar on 14th April, Tuesday. I'm going to talk about how to use repertory in acute cases, and especially about Phatak repertory and Bogor Bonninghausen repertory. I would want all of you to attend my talk and share with me. So let's come to the remedy today. We are talking about Hammam Alice. Hammam Alice belongs to the family of Hammamalidae, the family of cannabis. The main sensation of Hammamalidae is they feel a lot of pressure. They feel a lot of pressure, suffocated, and they want security, but they also want to go outside. They want to experience things. They want stimulation. One of the main things I've seen about Hammam Alice is that these are people who want a lot of respect. Not like Staphylococcus, who feel insulted. Hammam Alice is a little different. They want respect to be shown to me, or respect should be shown to me. They need a lot of respect. And you'll see that with many professors in the college and people who feel they have not got their due. You'll see them all around you, all around people. They feel that, oh, mere ko respect nahi diya gaya. That is Hammam Alice. And typically these patients who have this respect can often have concomitant symptoms in which Hammam Alice is known for, and that is for a lot of varicose ulcers, for venous ulcers, for throat infections, for piles. So that's why when there is a lot of soreness of the area around the veins, around the piles, around the varicose veins, with a lot of bleeding, often after operation it supersedes the use of morphia. So it's like a strong painkiller form of medication, Hammam Alice is. So imagine now with anatomy and pathophysiology, anywhere where there is varicosity, think about this remedy. So you can think about it for ecchymosis, you can think about traumatic affection, phlebitis, post-pregnancy, varicose ulcers, very sore, lot of pain, neuralgia around the saphenous vein, cervical pains, hemoptysis, chest infection, very important for ovarian affections, uterine hemorrhage with pain in the back, again lot of soreness, metrorrhagia between periods, intermenstrual pain, hemorrhoids, sore nipples after pregnancy. So after pregnancy, after operations, just like Staphylococcus, I think Hammam Alice comes very close to Staphylococcus. Pain around the spermatic cord, varicose seal, yes. Hematuria with high sexual desire. Hemorrhoids with soreness, anus is very sore, pulsations in that area, hematemesis, a lot of varicosities of the throat, eye, also ocular problems, so absorption of intraocular hemorrhage as well, bloodshot eyes, and fullness, numbness. So these are all symptoms of Hammam Alice. I think it's a lesser used remedy. It's a hot patient also. You should compare calcarea flor muriatic acid also, and it's very close to the remedy. Fair. Let's come to the next remedy. Hecla lava is a remedy also I use a lot. The main thing about Hecla lava is there's a lot of anger and violence in this remedy. The temper can be so much that they can burst in anger. Can often come very close to, it's an intensified state of snake remedy where there is kind of an explosion of anger, a little bit like lysinum. I use this remedy especially in jaw tumors, in tumors where there is osteosarcoma or osteitis, or tumors, bony tumors, or metastasis of the bone, but jaw tumors also. But especially when post caries, there is a lot of pain in the teeth. Think about it, gums abscess also. My main symptom is neuralgia after caries teeth or after extraction. It should be differentiated with hypericum. Hypericum has more pain, but Nicola Lava has more neuralgia. Think about Staphysagra also. I've used a couple of cases. And tumorous bone, swelling around the teeth. Conquiolinum is another remedy you should think about, C remedy. Think about it. So this is a little bit about Nicola Lava. Let's go on to the next remedy, Hedioma. I have not used this remedy too often, to be honest. But typically, it's a very important remedy for renal stones, for nephrotic cases, especially pain around the ureter. And there's a lot of pain in the left side of the ureter. So it comes very close to tabacum berberis. The main symptom is that there's a lot of burning in that area, constant desire to pass urine, but they cannot keep urine for a long time. They have to constantly pass urine. So this symptom is very important here. And bearing down sensation, backaches. Typically, urine and ovaries are symptoms are concomitant, more or less. Pain in the thumb joint, tendo achilles is painful, sprained and swollen. Comes close to medorhinum in that context. This is more or less what I wanted to talk about. It. Everything, it's very important for gastritis also. Whatever is eaten causes a lot of pain. So think about it as well. This is Hedioma also. Pennyroyal it's called this. Let's come to the next remedy, Hedera helix. It's a very important remedy in today's times. And one of the main thing it should be known for is for chronic hydrocephalus and also brain tumors. Concomitant, there's also coryza along with it. Cases where there's recurrent convulsions also. And the intracranial pressure goes high with mental state. Very, very depressed. Think about Hedera helix. Give it in low potency, frequent repetition. Very important remedy, underused remedy. We need to use this more often in pathological cases. So this is Hedera helix. What else can I tell you today? Okay, let's come to one more remedy. Helix tosta, very, very important remedy for hemoptysis. Bleeding, it's a bleeding remedy. It's a remedy for bleeding, especially chest infections. Another remedy, sunflower. The remedy sunflower, interesting remedy for today's times. It's for fevers, acute fevers, and a lot of coryza, thick scabs like Kalibai. It's a splenic remedy. Mouth remains dry, rheumatic pains around the joints, and a lot of vomiting, which is along with the dryness. There's a lot of dryness inside. So it also belongs to the compositor family, like a little bit like Eupatorium. So it's also used for post-injury. So it's an interesting remedy, but we need to know more about this remedy to use it, to be honest with you. Helitropium, it should be remembered along with one of the Natrum group of remedy. It's a very important remedy for uterine displacement with active bearing down sensor. Active means there's a lot of pain, little bit complementary to sepia and also complementary to one natrum compound, I think natrum hypochloricum. So yeah, so I hope you're watching my talk, and I hope you're reading this, and I hope you're making use of everything. Join me on my webinar, please.